The only true authentic event in Islamic history that took place on the 10th of Muharram was this: Allah Ta'ala delivering Musa alayhi salam and his people from the oppression of Firoun and his army. Some people, even lecturers in the bayans, they mention many other incidents, such as, for example, on the 10th of Muharram, they say Yunus alayhi salam got deliverance from the belly of the fish. They say Nuh alayhi salam, the deluge, the flood ended, and his boat settled on the top of a mountain on the 10th of Muharram. They say Namrud threw Ibrahim alayhi salam into the fire on the 10th of Muharram. Many such incidents, but these narrations are baseless. They are not proven. Lecturers make bayan of these incidents, but they are not authentic. The only authentic incident is the deliverance of Musa alayhi salam and his people from Fir'aun and his army. So because of these other events, Allah Ta'ala saved Hazrat Yunus alayhi salam, Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam, Nuh alayhi salam. They say even Adam alayhi salam's dua, repentance, was accepted on the 10th of Muharram. Always is baseless. So because of these amazing events, some deviated groups known as the Nawasib, they actually regarded the 10th of Muharram as a day of Eid. They wear the best clothes, they apply surma in the eyes, like celebrating a day of Eid. This is totally baseless, unfounded. And the martyrdom of Hazrat Hussain radiallahu ta'ala and his family, yes, that did take place on the 10th of Muharram, but that occurred after the demise of Nabi Karim Sahasam, many years after. So on the one extreme, the Nawasib, celebrating it as a day of Eid. On the other extreme, the Rawafis, the Shias, they declare this day as a day of mourning, of wailing. They come onto the streets in a procession. They beat their chests. Hum na the. We were not there in Karbala. If you had been there, what error would we have shot there? What would you have done? Nothing whatsoever. Mere lip service. You cannot put your money where your mouth is. Mere slogans. To regard this day as a day of mourning is also totally unfounded, baseless. If Islam had to declare any day for mourning, what greater tragedy than the demise of Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? That would have been declared as a day of mourning, of grief, of sadness. So these are the two extremes. And the Sunnah al-Jamaat, khayrul umur aw satwa, in between, the middle course of moderation.